Welcome to today's broadcast. I'm reading from the book of John, chapter 1, and verse number 4 in the Good News Bible. The Word was the source of life, and this life brought light to humanity. Hallelujah! Whoa! The source of everything determines three things. Number one, the function. Number two, the future. Number three, the future of a thing. When you know the source of a thing, you are able to determine the capacity of that thing. Now, this scripture said the Word was the source of life. So, the life of God, which is what we call Zoe, is at its source in the Word of God. So, that scripture said in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. That Word is the source of life. So whenever you need life in anything, financial life, mental health life, you know, spiritual life, relationship life, anything that you need life on, the Word of God has to come first. It's the source. Because the Word of God is the source, that's why the Word of God determines how anything functions. If you function very well, the Word of God is at work in your life. Anything that is not functioning in your life is because the Word of God is no more there. It's the source. The source determines the function. Number two, the source determines the future. What are the characteristics of life? You know, if the Word of God is the source of anything, the characteristics of that thing will be found in the world. And then the future of whatever you do. How powerful, how long, how durable, what is the future of a thing is determined by the source of that thing. So this scripture said the Word was the source of life. So the question is, if anybody tells you that because you breathe oxygen, you breathe in and breathe out, that's your source. No. That doesn't work that way. In the kingdom of God, the Word of God is the source of life. And then he went on and said, that life brought light to humanity. So darkness endure whenever the Word of God is not present. The light of God is the Word of God. The Word of God. He said God gave a word and it lighted in Israel. So the light of God is the Word of God. You know, until the Word of God come, darkness will endure. So if you want to enjoy the light of God, you must find the Word of God to become the source of all that you do. Whenever the Word of God appear, light of God come. When God said, let there be light, it was the Word of God that switched on the light of God in such darkness. So, if you begin to speak the Word of God in any area of your life, you're going to see the light of God coming up in everything that you do. Knowing the source helps you to understand the resources. Knowing that the source of life is the Word of God makes you understand the resources that are in the Word of God. It makes you crave for it. You're not reading it like a duty, like you want to pass an exam. It's because just the way you breathe in oxygen and breathe out carbon dioxide is the way you know that the source of your life is the Word of God. So it becomes a habit to enjoy the Word of God, to want to stay with the Word of God. The way you charge your phone because you want your phone to have life. That's exactly how charging your life with the Word of God brings you health. It brings you prosperity. It brings you safety and sanity. It brings life to your children. It makes you enjoy life. The enemy will just keep doing and keep wasting your time because the Word of God is at work in your life. It's called Zoe. It produces the life of God, the very life of God inside of you. The Word of God is the foundation of life of God in a man. So, until the Word of God comes, you don't have a foundation. The Word of God is the foundation of the Word of God. You must enjoy the Word of God. You must see it so important that it's your life. So, the issue of the Word of God, let me say this now, is the issue of life and death. The more of the Word, the more of life. Without the Word, you are a dead man. No matter how many times you pray in a day, no matter if you sleep inside church, what brings God to anything you want in life is the Word of God. So you must crave for the Word. You must eat it. You must prefer it than your necessary meat. That's what the book of Psalms said. Say, I prefer the Word of God more than my necessary meat. The way your body is shaking when you have not eaten for 1 day or 2 days or few hours is the way you should be uncomfortable when you have not eaten the Word of God. I want you to write it on that ear. The Word of God is the source of life. God bless you. See you tomorrow.